There you go. Well done. So you see why the whistling isn't like necessary, but he associates the whistle with the food. So if he can't see us when I whistle, he'll come looking. That's why we whistle all day when we're calling. Now we're going to go for a walk in the woods. He will fly very close to you while we're in here. Okay. You might actually like, feel him pass over your head and stuff.
Okay.
But he won't crash into you because he's built for flying in close spaces. So you might feel like, say, like a wingtip touch your head or something, but you'd be completely safe. But at all times, try to watch how he manoeuvres in the forest. The short wing with the small gap and the long tail happens here. So we hit and ride again. What are you like? He's like, yeah, you carry me. She's happy to do it. Now, you can either carry or cast him off, but the more exercise for him is to just
fly. There you go.
There you go. I'll leave this in your gloves and have you ready for when we need it again. You tell me if I can help. So, you know, there might be like a slight behavior change in here where you're seeing the point of that with the high trees around you. And then because he's social, because he's like a pack hunter, he can see that you become like an extension of us. You're the same as us, so you're okay. You know, they'll feed me too. It's all good.
Oh, right there.
It'll rain on me. Thank you, Aaron.